Welcome everyone back to Barbecue Gymnasium. Yes, it's been a long night. We've seen four fantastic ball games. Last game in the JV Championship division went into overtime with Packer being able to pull it out in overtime. The 4-point win over Burning Springs. And the two teams will also meet here in the Varsity division, which my understanding is they played two overtime games themselves this year. So, looking for another great game.
Manchester Enterprise, first high school main varsity championship game. Now, he's going to line up first four Hacker. Guardian guard, number 23, Noah Jackson. Guardian guard, number 21, Trey Crawford.
Starting lineups have been announced. It's going to be a good one. About 1,500 people in this gym right now. Good atmosphere for basketball. So we got Jackson and Sizemore jumping center. Burning Springs is in the white, Hacker's in the black. Something on the clock malfunction because it knocked out 30 seconds. Try it again. Third time's a charm out here. Let's see what happens. Hacker will get it first. That's Desarn, 24. Things had a pretty good look. No points. Double zeros, Carter Hacker. And Hacker's going to call a quick timeout. Didn't like the way that they were running their offense. We'll be right back. good idea, trying to get the ball to Connor Murray right there, slicing down the middle. Just a little overshot. Skyler Sizemore, good looking ball player here for Bernie Springs. Acker in a 2-3 zone. Brody Brumley with a miss. We have balls flying in here from everywhere. Sorry, Carter Hacker, first bucket. Springs, 2-0. This is a championship game in the varsity division. 5th and 6th graders. First bucket for Bernie Springs. Ties it up at 2. Halfway through the first quarter. Hacker at the line for Hacker, and he has missed the first free throw. 2:17 to go in the first quarter. Game started out a little slow here, but got to figure nerves are factoring in a little bit. I suspect the action will pick up, buckets will be made. Springs. Noah Jackson had a monster game in the semifinals, scoring 23. Jackson Foster foul. Bernie Springs the other night in the semifinals. I look for him to have a good game also. Two quick fouls on Foster. 34.6 to go, 4-2 opening quarter of the Varsity Championship. Four to four. Under 30 seconds. Hustle by both teams. Three-pointer would have went, would have counted, but had it went. We're 4-4 after one period in the championship game. Bernie Springs foul to start the second quarter. Not much scoring there in the first quarter. I believe just, you know, both teams got some good shots. Didn't make them. I think they'll settle down here. Brody Brumley going to go for the line. Referee Mark Jackson said the man got him with the body. Four, Bernie Springs. Bryson Hubbard didn't like the fact that that foul was called on him. By the big guy. Connor Murray. Got a rebound. Straight Crawford with the ball. Jackson. 8-7 Hacker. Four and a half to go here in the first half. Championship game of the varsity division. Little give and go action there. People don't realize how effective that actually is. Tried to force that one inside. Back to Sizemore, 12-footer. It's a good move, but I actually think it was a good call. It was a lot of contact, but he did lower his shoulder. He was going to the goal. Zarn back in the game. Nice strong drive. Skyler Sizemore. Definitely one of the big reasons why they are in the championship game. I'm digging the green shoes.
You don't let it talk to you!
Got it. Well, day. Might have missed that entire play, I'm not sure. Either way, Dyson Hubbard has picked up a foul. Austin Gibson has picked up another one for Bernie Springs. We're trying to put a lot of pressure on the guards, which is probably a good idea. .246 to go in the first half, 12-8, Burnham Springs on top. That's going to be a foul on Hacker. Double-zero Carter Hacker. A little over-aggressive there. Skyler Sizemore picked that foul up, and I believe it will be the bonus for Hacker. With 2:16 to go. Packers only committed three team fouls, so they still got a couple fouls to give before Bernie Springs will be shooting them. It's no good. Rebound by Jackson, up and in. Cuts the lead to two, 12-10. Trey Crawford with the rebound, slowly going to move the ball up. Good post pass, good post move, just missed it. And there'll be another foul on Carter Hackett. It's going to send him to the bench. And it's going to be a timeout on the floor. 1:43 to go here in the opening half. 12-10, Bernie Springs. Porter. 15-10. Crawford all the way to the bucket. Nice strong move. 15-12, under a minute. Sizemore got fouled on the way up. 45 seconds to go here in the opening half. Bernie Springs on top by three, 15-12. Isaiah Jackson checking in for Hackett. Crawford a three off the mark. Sizemore, nice move. It's a good ball player. Austin Gibson on the foul. Send Isaiah to the line. See if he can cut into this Bernie Springs lead. 17-12. Hughes inbounding the ball there to Sizemore. Looking for one shot. Around the 5 seconds. Montgomery tried to make it along the baseline, did not. But Bernie Springs is going to take a 17-12 halftime lead in the boys' varsity division. Stay with us. And now truly one of the big moments everybody's been waiting on. That's the cheerleading competition they've already had. And they're just going to announce the winners here at halftime. Thank you. lot cranky. Don't know who's more nervous, the parents or the sponsors or the kids. Maybe equally so.
All right, if I can have your attention, please, it's time for the First National Bank Manchester Enterprise Cheerleading Awards. And first, we're going to give out the Spirit Award. And this year, it goes to Oneida. First and fourth division, fourth place goes to Paces Street.
For the second half tip-off, or the first possession of the second half. It's Hacker in the black, trailing by five. Recovery on the wing, good. Brantley Desarn. They backed off of him, he made them pay. Brumley no good. Jackson with the ball. Trying another one, no good. Rebound up and in though. That was Connor Murray. 17 all, five in a row for Hacker. Jackson Foster got good position on the weak side rebound. Got foul on the way back up. Hacker outscored Burnett Springs 5-0 here to start the second half. Up the second, puts Burnett Springs back on top, 18-17. Burnett Springs going to full court press a little bit here. By Foster. Taken right back away by Hacker. That's Bizarre with the basketball. He's gonna walk it up. A good old double low post. Strip, took the length, got the bucket. Burnett Springs back up by three, 20-17, 3.5 to go here in the third quarter. Hacker was taking that one to the goal no matter what. Got tripped in there. I believe the foul's on Sizemore, number three. Good defensive pressure, forced a turnover. Was unkind there. Stays 20-17. 2.5 to go here in the third quarter. Burnett Springs on top. That'll be a reach in. Foul on Hubbard. Hacker will have to get him on track if they want to win this championship, I believe. Have a 1-3-1 look here for Hacker. Go! Foster rips down another rebound. That's Sizemore on the drive. He's going to be hacked. Minute 16 to go. Third quarter. 2019, Bernie Springs clinging to a one-point lead. Lead was five at halftime, but Hacker came straight out and scored five in a row to start the third quarter. But since then, they've kind of traded around a little bit. 20-19. Sizemore for two. Timeout, 1:02 to go here in the third quarter. Bernie Springs leads it 20-19. Bryson Bell, a little zealous with his defense there of his arm. Corner, good. Bale drains a three. Time's running short here in the third period. 4-point lead for Bernie Springs. They led by five at the half. Three seconds. Charging foul there. 8 tenths. And that'll do it for the third period. Bernie Springs is going to be on top. 23-19 going to the final stanza of the Clay County Great School Varsity Championship. Stay with us. This is it, fourth quarter. Good play design, but better defensive effort. The big man for Hacker could not save it. Good effort, 23-19. Three-pointer, no good. Tyler Sizemore relentless on the boards that time. Got it to go, is also fouled. The bucket is counted. Got a chance for the old-fashioned three-point play. It's 25-19 with 4:49 to go in the ball game. Missed it. Got the rebound. Wants a timeout, and we'll take it with them. 25-19, Ernest Springs in the lead. 4:41 to go in the ball game. Skylar Sizemore back to the line. Quick, but I actually believe it was a good call there by Stumpy. I think we got to run something for Jackson here. A hacker needs a bucket. With the bucket, nice pass there from Sizemore. This game's going to get away from Hacker. They need a bucket. Two to go in the ball game, 28-19. Lead's grown out to 9. Hacker needs something good to happen here. Bucket, a turnover, another bucket. Something to tighten this game up. It's Crawford at the line. Layup. Biggest lead of the game. 30-19. I didn't see who the foul was on. I don't doubt it was a foul. I just didn't see the number. Is mushrooming now. All the momentum is on Bobcat's side. 32-19. Beautiful drive there by Skylar Sizemore. Hacker has got to stop the bleeding. Yeah. say Coach Culver probably had rather just had his point guard there, Sizemore, just back off and let him have the layup at this point. Save that foul. And I believe that's four on him, if I'm not mistaken. They needed. Surprised them with the press. Now if they can find points. Well, that was a golden opportunity. But Mr. Jackson is set over and back. Thirty-two-20, 2.5 to go here in the ball game. Crawford, a good move to the goal, got fouled. Like he got hit on the forearm, trying to shoot it. He's going to go to the line and shoot too. 32-20. And they're going to have to make every shot from here on out, and they're going to have to force some turnovers if they want to get back in it. Made one of two. There's going to be a timeout on the floor. 2:24 to go in the championship game. Got position inside, went up strong, didn't make the shot, but he did get fouled. 32-21, Burning Springs on top. Minute 53 to go. It will probably be a free throw shooting contest here on out. Burning Springs may need to make a few of them. There's one. Second half, but that was a big bucket. Turnover. They need some of those. They're down by 10. They also have to convert on the offensive end down here. Yeah. Isaiah Jackson on the foul. They'll be forced, actually. I think that's the one and one. They'll be forced to foul every time Burning Springs gets possession now. And then they got to hope they miss him. Ten-point lead. Burning Springs basketball. If Hacker cannot get a steal right off, they will foul and put somebody at the line. There you go. Should be double bonus for both teams now. See there, have an opportunity to score without the clock running. 49.7 to go. Still a 7-point game for the Bobcats. 33-26. Carter Hacker at the line, shooting two. Both teams have struggled at the free throw line. And Hustle got the rebound, put it back in. Cuts it down to a 5-point game. Another foul. I wouldn't go anywhere just yet. Bryson Hubbard left-handed. Got it. Big first run. Got them both. Huge free throw. Takes the lead back to 7. Hacker's got to be in a hurry. That was brilliant out of bounds play. Got his shot blocked. Got the hustle, got the ball back. Now has the opportunity to have a 3-point play. The big man for Vernon Springs has fouled out. Played a great ball game, young man. Great game. Jackson Foster. Thirty-five, 30, 28 and a half to go. I assure you, I've seen stranger things in games, and you probably have too. Got it. Two possession game. Who would have thought that a few minutes ago? Carter has fouled him. Make sure that the ref saw it. And that's going to be five on target. He's out. Make three big ones in a row. I said they'd have to make some free throws down the stretch. They have. Made them both. 6-point lead. .6. Man, that might have just done it. Let's see if Brumley can continue this hot streak at the free throw line. That's 5 in a row, really in the last minute. Played a nice ball game. Made them both. Huge free throw. Clutch. .8. This one here, they Hacker has backed off, and Bernie Springs is going to be your Varsity Great School Champions. Another thrilling ball game to say the least. 39-31, Bernie Springs is your county champion over the Hacker Wildcats. Need to stay tuned. We do have some awards to give out. All-tournament team, MVP, those type things. So stick with us. And we'll be right back.
To the winning coach. If you'll go from the center circle with Mark, you will present the game ball to you. The eyes of the first night's point, the main jury for Enterprise, presenting Mark Hollister, presenting the game ball to the winning coach. Okay, now for the team trophies. First for the 2023 First Knights of Lake Mount Jersey Enterprise runner-up in the Varsity Division goes to Hacker. We'd like to ask everyone to please stay out for play and hover until I can get our trophies and everything to give out.
Well, a heck of a ball game. Great season. Hacker and Bernie Springs, neither one strangers for county championships, that's for sure. Looking ball player right here. Long, handles the ball.
And now for our all-tournament team. From Goose Rock, Lucas Hanson. From Onita, Caden Napier. From Big Creek, Corbin Lewis. From Manchester, Ryder Smith. From Manchester, Cooper DeZarn. From Paces Creek, Ben Hoskins. From Paces Creek, Reagan Jackson. From Bernie Springs, Austin Gibson. From Bernie Springs, Brody Brumley. From Bernie Springs, Aaron Owens. And from Bernie Springs, Bryson Hubbard, and from Burns Springs, Skyler Sathmore. From Hacker, Trey Crawford. From Hacker, Nolan Jackson. From Hacker, Carter Hacker. From Hacker, Connor Murray. And from Hacker, Bentley DeZarn.
All tournament team has been announced. Bernie Springs County champions in the varsity division, 39-31 over the Hacker Wildcats. Excellent ball game. The junior varsity went into overtime in the championship game. Hacker was able to pull it out late over Bernie Springs. Great basketball. Man, they must have been 1,500 people here tonight. What a great crowd. Sure proud of our town to come out and support these youngsters. Congratulations to the cheerleaders who competed and won their awards, and of course the academic all-county teams as well. My name's Eddie Smith. Glad you could join us. You can check this out. I'll have a link over to Facebook when it's on our YouTube channel, the Southeast Kentucky Network. And of course, as always, we'll have it on TV on the Cats TV Network. Appreciate you guys for joining us. Hope you enjoyed the broadcast, and good night.